You know, as storms roll in, Duke crews are now rolling out, ready to attack outages so that you're not left in the dark, at least for long. News host John London spent the day with workers, and he joins us live tonight. John, it looks like they're going to be busy tonight.
Well, they're prepared for it, Cherie. Extra lines, cables, supplies have been working on that all day. That's part of the preparation that has been going on here at the maintenance facility for Duke Energy. Assessors will head out after the storm if needed to pinpoint problem areas. For a third time in a week, they're at the gate.
Duke Energy crews have already had a crowded day, tracking radar and preparing crews. Coming off two storms in the past week that took power from 68,000 last week, 42,000 this week.
The hot temperatures, when we have crews that are working extra hours, we have to make sure that they're maintaining their own safety and making sure they're staying hydrated.
Tammy and Ray can relate. They lost power along Huber Trace Court in Fairfield before 11 this morning.
Flash, and then it went out, and then the neighbor came over to see if ours was out because he has out-of-town company.
And at mid-afternoon when we came calling, they were still garage-sitting along with their 8-year-old dog Ace, wondering what in the name of Thomas Edison's going on.
We both have medical conditions, and the heat is definitely takes a toll on us. So.
With a stormy forecast of potential power-busting capacity, the folks in this subdivision were sweating in more ways than one.
Well, we're worried about it because the house is starting to get a little warm.
Down the street, Denny Brown brushed off the storm clouds. He had more urgent priorities.
Inconvenience, I can't get my house.
With blood work scheduled, he had inadvertently left his medical cards inside along with the deadbolt key. Suddenly powerless, he found the garage door stubbornly still. So as the excessive heat warning hours stretched into late afternoon, blessed relief, a Duke Energy repair crew showed up. They found a Fairfield fix at Concord Mill and River. Turns out an old fuse switch overheated and blew. So for now, Denny, Tammy, Ray, and the rest are empowered once again.
And looking live here in Queensgate again, if there are outages, Sally Thielen of Duke Energy reminds you, don't assume the utility here knows you're out. Contact Duke if need be to report a power outage. It helps the utility know to get a good handle on where the outages have occurred, and there have already been a couple 3,000 of them in Hamilton County alone. Reporting live in Queensgate, John London, News.